Let's design and export a laser cut file in Blender. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about learning how to design and export laser cut files from Blender. The information we're going to be using is from my How to Create an Accurate Finger Joint Box video, but we will be creating this little more simplified version than the one that has a lid in that video. So let's go ahead and get straight into it. Just before we jump in, if you don't know anything about Blender, I have an entire free series of how to go about from a CAD workflow or from an Illustrator workflow into a Blender workflow using my Blender Precision series. It's in the card or it's linked in the description. So here we are on a nice fresh Blender file. Now the first thing I want to let you know is remember that within Blender, you can do things many ways to get to the same outcome. I've played around a little bit and I found that this is probably the most efficient way to get this. Now, if you feel like you don't know too much about Blender, remember what I said at the beginning, I have my entire Precision series for free on here on YouTube, so it's down in the description. So let's get to it. I'm going to delete this cube because we're doing laser cutting, which means we're probably going to be working within a 2D plane for most of this. So let's get a plane up. We're going to be using the exact same dimensions as in my other video. So let's go ahead and set the Y to 90 millimeters and set the X to 75 millimeters. Now we've just screwed up the scale. So let's just quickly apply that scale so that it's all one once again. And now let's go ahead and create a cube. Now with this cube, we're going to set these are our cutaways for our fingers. So let's go ahead and set the Y to 10 millimeters and set the X to 3 millimeters. Oops, 3 millimeters there, please. And you were going, oh God, I've screwed this up properly. Let's go Y, 10, X, 3. And then from here, we're going to use CAD transforms quickly to just go ahead and move this cube from here to there. And on top of that, we're going to move our origin point. So let's go ahead, a new shortcut here, which is Control Shift Alt to change the Blender snapping point quickly. And let's go shift, right click, snap down there, and set the origin point to the 3D cursor. And the reason why we're doing this is because we are going to be using the array modifier. So we're going to hit array. We're going to go 1 on the Y. No, not 1, 2 on the Y, 0 on the X. And we're going to go up a couple of times, because we're going to place these fingers all along here. Fantastic. With that now in place there, we're going to go ahead and just quickly do one small edit. We're just going to plop this face extruded out just a tiny bit, because when we're cutting about, this is going to be a coplanar cut, which won't give us good results. Now, what we're going to do, once again, using this shortcut, we're going to go edge centers, going to move our middle mouse, our 3D mouse to the middle here, and we're going to move this origin point to the 3D cursor. Now, the reason why we're doing that is we're about to use another modifier, which is the mirror modifier that uses the origin point as the mirror location. So there we go. That's almost our fingers now in place. So the keen-eyed of you have probably realized that this is only one face of a finger joint box. So let's duplicate this, move this on the X. We're going to select this here in the array. We're going to go down a count, and then we're going to grab our object, go G, Y, 10, and here we have it almost done. Now, due to how the bool tool currently works, I have a feeling in 2.9 this is going to be fixed. But we're going to have some problems with coplanars if we did a cutaway right this minute. So let's go into here, let's apply the array, and then let's go into face selection, and we're going to select these two faces here, and the two faces on the other side here. Now I'm just going to do a quick scale outwards just to make them bigger, and that should pretty much be it. So let's go and select our cutting objects, move them on the Z just a little bit, And now we're going to be able to select, shift select, control shift minus, and select, shift select, control shift minus. So that there is already our fingers in place. So let's go ahead and do the bottom. So the bottom wise, we have our 3D cursor down there. So let's go ahead and create another cube. So we're here at this cube now, and let's go and set the dimensions here. We're going to go for an X of 10, a Y of 3, and I have a feeling that I'm wanting it somewhere around over there. So let's go on here. Let's go X 15. Yeah, that looks about right. And then from here, I'm just going to go and snap this up. So let's go G, Y, we have edge middle selected, so this should work. There we go, and holding down control, it will snap there. And the reason why is I'm going to go Y, so G, Y, 3, so we have 3 millimeters of wood down there. So with that set, we have our 3D cursor still in place. I'm going to go ahead and set the origin to the 3D cursor, do a mirror modifier here, and now let's go ahead and duplicate this over here. So I'm going to go ahead and move the 3D cursor back to that middle point here. I'm going to select this, go Shift D, right click, and then I'm going to go Shift S, and we're going to go active to 3D cursor. Now where's that? Selected to cursor, fantastic. And now we can just go Shift Select, Control Shift Minus, Shift Select, Control Shift Minus. So that's our faces basically done. So let's do our bottom now. So to do the bottom, I'm going to select one of these. I'm going to go here, go Edge Select, and I'm going to select these loops right here. I'm going to go Shift D, move them down on the Y. I will go for P for popping them out of the selection. So here we have these separated out. These will come into play later on, so let's leave them there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back here into vertex selecting. I'm not going to do vertex selecting. I'm just going to go and move this 3D cursor over here. And let's create another plane. Fantastic. And this plane, we're going to go ahead and we're going to snap that vertex up there. I'm going to go use CAD transforms for this. And there to there. And now we're going to do scaling. So let's go S. We're scaling this point here on 2 dimensions. So hit a tab over to that vertex there. Fantastic. Let's move this down. Now, we don't need CAD transforms for that though, so G, Y, move this down, fantastic. And now, let's go ahead, select these here, and let's go into edit mode, select everything, fill them up, and now let's go and snap these down to here. So, we're going to go, I'm going to use CAD transforms because I'm a fan of it, and let's go Y to the edge. There. So we've now got edge snapping done here. Fantastic. Now let's go ahead and move the 3D cursor to that selected point there. So, and that's Shift S, cursor to active. And the reason why is we're going to move this origin point to there. So right click, set origin, origin to 3D cursor. And I think you've guessed what's going to happen next. But just before we do that, I'm going to go ahead and go into edit mode, select these edges here, and just bring them down a touch. And yes, those are coplanar, but you'll see that there is a way to work around it. So with that done, let's use our mirror modifier once again. And this time we're doing it on the Y and not the X. And I'm going to actually apply this, and then we're going to select this, Shift D to duplicate it, R, Z to rotate, and go 90. Then we're going to select everything of that's here, and we're going to join it by Control J, so now it's all one object, but they're still separate objects in edit mode. But now if we select everything, and we use our tiny CAD, and we use intersect all edges. Boom, that's done. Now we'll do, go into the top view, let's go C for circle select and select everything that we're not wanting here. So we're not wanting any of those, none of these here, none of those there, or those. I think you're getting the point of what I'm doing here. Then we're going to delete these edges, select everything once again, hit M, merge by distance, and that there is our bottom part created. Let's select that, fill it up because this doesn't need anything else. And that there is basically the box designed. Now, our tolerances and offsets haven't been done yet, so let's do that now. So from the video of how to design accurate finger joint boxes for laser, you should know your laser tolerance and offset that you need to apply. So for me, it's still 0.08, and let's go ahead and apply this. So I'm going to select all of these, going to go Control J, so they're all the same object. We're going to go into edit mode, and I'm going to select all my edges that I need to do an offset on. So this time around, I am actually just selecting everything here, and we're going to go edge, offset, and offset edge. And then we're going to go ahead and go 0.08 and hit enter. Fantastic. Remember that if you don't know how to do this, I do have an offset video, and you'll see everything that I've used right there in action. So with that done, we're going to hit P, export the selected, and then we can hide our other file. So we're going to go ahead, I'm going to rename this file as well and call this ref for reference. And here we have our actual file. Now, unfortunately, outline to SVG does not work with just this, so we need to give it some surfaces. So I'm going to show you two ways to go about it. So the first way is, let's go here into our edit mode of this object. And what we're going to do is go vertex select, and we're going to manually select our vertices and connect them up as so. So that's one way of doing it. And then what we do is, once we have our face created this way, I'm going to go into our edge select, circle select, select all the edges that we want one face to be. We're going to go and fill that up, and then we're going to do select the rest of it. So select that, and this one here, and we're selecting that and that. So that's one way to create that into a face. The other way to go and create this into a face is going ahead, selecting these here, and let's go and fill those, and we're going to extrude them out a bit. Oops, I accidentally had an edge selected there, so let's go and undo that there. Make sure that I only have what I'm wanting selected. Let's fill those, extrude these out a little bit, then we're going to select these all once again, go G, Z, move them down just a touch, and the reason why is now we have some cutting objects here. So let's go ahead, select the faces of these, and let's part these out by selections for later use. Let's go and select this whole edge loop here, fill that up. Let's go ahead, grab those there, and we can then just take away. So those are two different ways of going about it. Lastly, I want to show you one other way of how to turn everything into a solid surface. And this is probably the one that you're wanting to use if you have a lot of things that you need to turn into a solid surface quickly. So we're going to go into edit mode, select everything up, extrude this out on the Z a little bit, and now we're going to go out of there into object mode, and we're going to create a nice plane. Now from this plane, we're going to go ahead and extrude it up the material thickness. I'm going to go for 3 here, then I go back into object mode, move this up on the Z a bit, and now here's the cool bit. If you select this and select that, and now you go Control Shift times, this here is going to do the differential, and I think it's differential. Let me just double check that for you. It is the intersect. It is an intersection bool. So with the intersection bool, we're able to get this. Now this can be great, but do be aware that the normals can be a little bit funny, and that can screw out outline to SVG. So maybe one thing to do here is go like this, create these into solid objects, and then once these are created into solid objects, take a look at it from some sort of side view, go into edit mode, turn on X-ray, we're going to go into face selection, and just go ahead and select all the bottom faces here, and we can just delete all these faces. So you're just left with these flat planes, which you know Outline to SVG can support perfectly. They give near enough the same results. This one you have more precision and accuracy with in the long term if you're wanting to re-edit files. This one, it can sometimes give you some weird results. All right, last, let's go and fill this up here. And that there is basically the file ready. So let's go ahead and do our nesting quickly. I'm just going to do some manual nesting. So I'm going to go and part these in edit mode first. Then we're going to go part and by loose parts. So now we have each one of these individually. I'm going to go G, constrain this on the X. I don't need this just yet. G, constrain this. Go we go. Move that to there. And I'm just going to use my CAD transforms now quickly to get perfectly where I'm wanting things to be. Edge select, edge center to edge center. Then I'm going to move this once again on the Y by 1 millimeter. And with that done, I'm going to select these two, Shift D, move them on the X. And once again, using my CAD transforms, I'm going to go G, vertex, move that to there. And let's move this now on the X by 1 millimeter. Brilliant. Now let's grab this one here. And I'm going to snap it from here. Let's go to that one there. And once again, move this out by 1 millimeter on the X. Brilliant. And that's now all in place. So let's go ahead and export this. So we're going to go into our Outline to SVG add-on. We're going to set up a camera, view through the camera, and I think this is going to need to be about 250 millimeters. I'm going to just round this up to 300 actually. And then we're going to select all of these, use normal moving, constrain it so that it's a planar move, move this here into the center. Let's actually chuck this all into one object here. So we'll Control J. And now with that all selected, make sure that you've got the right DPI if you're an Inkspace or Illustrator. I'm personally going to use Illustrator, but this is exactly the same for Inkscape. So let's go ahead, hit there, select where you're wanting this file to be. I'm going to just chuck it onto my desktop. I'm going to also give this a file name, which I'll call it Fingerbox. And then from there, we're going to accept that. And now it's as easy as just going export SVG outline. This here is basically going to export it out. It's going to quickly open up Inkscape, join everything together and plop it out. And that's it. So let's go ahead and open that file. So with your file now in your vector editing program, it very much is up to you because depending on what laser you have is how you're going to be setting this up. I'll show you how it's done for a Glowforge, so I'm just going to quickly set this to nothing. Technically, that's already done right there, but what I'm also going to do is I want these holes here to be cut first because that means that there will be a more of an accurate cut for these holes. So I'm going to copy them out, delete them, and then I'm going to paste them back in. I'll change the color to, I don't know, let's go for orange. And with that there, all I have to do is export this as a PDF. And that's it, cut for me. And with that, you have your first laser cut file exported from Blender. And this is only just scratching the surface because Blender has procedural generation to node-based design. The sky is the limit, and I'm going to do my best to reach up there. Now, if you're interested on some more complicated designs, I have my puzzle box series where I'm teaching you how to create and design laser cut puzzle boxes. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are awesome and I really appreciate your support. And if you think I'm worthy of your support, I'd love to see you there too. Remember that all the useful links and information is down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.